In this Smartproxy integration tutorial, I'll show you how to use proxies with ParseHub. Start by launching the ParseHub application and clicking on the New Project button. Enter a link to a website you'd like to extract data from. Now, click Start Project with this URL and then enable the browse mode by clicking on a toggle. Great! It's time to get your proxy endpoints. Since the integration process is the same for all proxies, you can use any type you want. But for the purpose of this video, I'll be using residential proxies. Head straight to the Smartproxy dashboard and log in. Select the Proxy Setup option. In the Authentication Method field, type in the username of your choice. Hit Create. The password is generated automatically. Alternatively, you can choose IP whitelisting as an authentication option. Now, choose your preferred proxy user, location, session type, and output format in the Endpoint Generator section. Below, you'll find the generated endpoints. Copy them and go back to ParseHub. You will find the menu on the top right side of the app. Click on it and go to Preferences. Then, select Advanced. In the new window, you'll find the Network tab. Click on it and go to Settings. Here you need to configure your proxies. Start by selecting Manual Proxy Configuration. Fill in the proxy endpoint details in the HTTP proxy and port fields. If you're using a SOX proxy, fill in the SOX host field and leave others empty. Once you're done, click OK. Now, if you're using IP whitelisting as an authentication option, there's nothing more you need to do. But if you choose a username and password, you need to open a new tab in the browse mode and type in the credentials you generated in the Smartproxy dashboard. That's it. You've successfully added proxies to your ParseHub project. You'll find all the relevant links in the video description. For more helpful videos like this, check out our channel.